Hey guys, welcome to the session. In this session, we will explore inheritance in TypeScript. Inheritance is a key concept in object-oriented programming. I assume that you already have a knowledge of object-oriented concepts. If not, I will recommend you a course from edx.org. Go to edx.org. In the search box, type object-oriented programming. Press enter. This will list down certain options for this topic. Click the course from the IIT Bombay. IIT Bombay is one of the reputed institutions in India. This course will talk about the concepts like classes and methods, polymorphism, inheritance, and it will also describe examples using C++. I will recommend you this course so that you can gain the better understanding of object-oriented programming. Let us close this particular tab and we'll get back to TypeScript. Now, since JavaScript is a prototype-oriented language, it doesn't offer an option for this object-oriented concepts. But TypeScript fills that gap. TypeScript offers you an option of creating a class structure, sharing the state with the different operations within that class. Before we dive into the TypeScript actual code, let us understand the problem that we are trying to address over here. Take a case of a vehicle. Vehicle is a generalized representation of car, bus, motorcycle. If we had to design the vehicle class, we will try to group the common attributes and operations within that vehicle class. Let me just explain it using the UML diagram. We'll go to my favorite website draw.io, which will help you to create a UML diagram. UML is a unified modeling language used to represent various artifacts in software world. Go to the UML section and choose this class diagram. Click on the create button. It will actually create a default representation. Select all the elements and delete it. We'll create our own class structure. Collapse this general section, expand the UML. You'll find there are various symbols which are available to create this class diagram. We'll choose the basic one. So what we are going to do is that we are going to create a vehicle class. We'll name this entity as vehicle. We'll try to create the common attributes within the vehicle. So first, one of the basic attributes is that number of wheels. Let's call it as num of wheels. This will be of type number. Also, we will have a common attribute as engine type. So whether it is a petrol or a diesel or whether it is an electric car, we can specify that the type is basically a string. Let me expand this section so that it is visible. Okay. We will also add another attribute called as horn. Okay, so we'll just indicate whether horn is present or not. Again, we want to describe the common operations that a vehicle has. So almost all the vehicle can turn left or they can turn right. So we'll introduce a method turn left, which basically doesn't return anything. So it is of type void. We have turn right method, which again doesn't return anything. We will also have a method called as blow horn. So when we call this method, it will create a sound. Let's imagine that. So now our vehicle class is ready. It has defined common attributes which are usually required for most of the vehicles that we use. What we are now going to do is that we are going to create a car class, which is going to reuse all the definitions of vehicle and it is going to add its own customized behavior options. Name this new entity as car. Okay. Now car might have an additional attributes, as I said earlier. So let's assume that car has a climate control, which may not be present in all the vehicles. So we'll add those attributes over here, climate control. Let this define it as a type of string. So whether it is an automatic climate control or manually need to manage it, depending upon that type, it will store that information. Also, a car may have an automatic transmission. So we'll also define an attribute automatic transmission. Let's just define a type as Boolean. Let me expand it. Okay. Again, a car may have an operation like open hood, which may be very specific to a car class, because bikes usually don't have a hood. And let's assume that it is not going to return anything. Now, in order to define the inheritance relationship between the vehicle and car, we will have to use a specialized arrow operator. We see that there is an arrow which is tagged as generalization. Let us drag this arrow, put it over car. We'll turn the direction of this arrow and it will point to the vehicle entity. The annotation indicates that car is actually extending from a vehicle. This is how you represent the inheritance in UML. We will code this example in TypeScript. Go back to the command prompt. We will switch to a directory wherein we want to create this example. In my case, I use practice as a folder. We'll create a directory called as inheritance_typescript. Switch to this directory. We need to create the Node.js project in order to write this example. So I will initialize this directory with npm init. We're not going to customize the options, so I'll just press enter for all of these questions. Let this review it, press enter. This will create a file called as package.json in our project. Since we are going to use TypeScript, we'll also initialize the TypeScript project using tsc --init. This will create tsconfig.json. Go to Explorer. Okay, we have these two files. Open this project into Visual Studio Code. Now, in order to create the vehicle class, first create new file, name it as vehicle.ts. The vehicle class can be created using the class keyword. In order to define the body of this class, we need to make use of the curly brackets. So we have number of wheels, which is of type number. Okay. Now TypeScript will complain that you cannot just declare the variable and leave it as is. Either it needs to be initialized within the constructor, or when you're declaring it, initialize with some value. What we'll do is that we'll initialize it right over here. Then we have next attribute. So what are those next attributes? The next one is engine type, which is of type string, and then we have home. So we have engine type, which is again defined as a type of string. We'll define on, which is of type boolean. We'll assign the value as true. Now our vehicle class has three operations, turn left, turn right, and blow horn. Then just implement that as well. Turn left. It is not going to return anything. We'll just print a message into it. Console.log. Turn left, invoked from vehicle. We'll write turn right. Same message, console.log. Turn right, invoke from vehicle. The next method, blow horn, which is again not going to return anything. So again we put a message, don't honk. Let's leave in a peaceful world. So we are done with the class definition, but there is one requirement. In order to make use of this class, we will have to export it so that it can be referred in other TypeScript files. If we don't export it, this class definition is only available within this file. We will not be able to use it outside this class definition. And since we are going to create a new definition for car, we need the vehicle class to be made available. Only then the inheritance is possible. Go back to the editor and create a new file called as car.ts. Again, the same step, we'll create class, the class keyword, and this time we are going to extend the vehicle. So use extends as a keyword, type vehicle. See, Visual Studio Code is able to identify the class that we created in the earlier step, and it is happening because we are using TypeScript. TypeScript is feeding those hints to Visual Studio Code that these are the set of entities or classes definition are available within this project. If you just select it and press enter, it will also automatically add the import statement on the top of this particular file. We don't have to manually type it. This is the beauty of TypeScript. Let us define the body of car class. Open close the curly brackets. Switch back to the UML diagram. We have attributes like climate control and automatic transmission. So let's say climate control. Instead of type string. Automatic transmission. Instead of type boolean. Again, we'll say that by default the automatic transmission is not available. Now we have to make use of the operations. Open hood, define the operation as well. Open hood is not going to again return anything, so we just declare it as void. Let us print a message, console.log. Hood is open. Let's just export this class so that we can use it in another file. Create a new file. Let's just name it as index.ts. That's a starting or entry point for our Node.js project. We are now going to instantiate the car class. In order to instantiate it, we need to create a variable which is of type car. So we are creating a variable which is named as C, whose type is car. Press enter. We are going to initialize it, so is equal to new car. See, new is a keyword which is used in most of the language in order to create an object of a class. We are done with the creation of the car class, and now we have created an instance of a car class. Let's just invoke few methods on this instance. So we'll type C. In order to access the attribute or the operations of this particular instance, we have to make use of the dot operator. You will see that Visual Studio Code is actually going through the definitions of the car and the vehicle class, and it is listing down all the publicly accessible properties and the operations. So some of the methods like turn left, turn right, blow horn is actually fetched from the vehicle, and open hood is fetched from the car class. All these methods are available because of inheritance. Let's just call one of the method, turn left. So now we have just called a method turn left. Let's just save this file. Go to the command prompt. Type TSC. Press enter. This will compile all the files in our project. So you will see that now there is a file for car, which is named as car.js. File for vehicle, vehicle.js, and our entry point, that is index.js. You can go back to the command prompt and type node index.js. Aha, there is a message. It says that turn left invoke from a vehicle. If I call the method which is defined within the car class itself, say open hood, save it. Again, we are going to recompile it, execute it using the node index.js command. You will see that two messages are now getting printed. Turn left invoke from a vehicle and hood is open. You might have got the basic understanding of how to implement inheritance in TypeScript. That's all for this lecture. Thank you.